Welcome back to the Morecambe and Wise Show from 1978. Welcome back! Today we're making a traditional sherry trifle. Unlike the Jennifer Aniston method, Charo the chef will be leaving out the beef sautéed with peas and onions. My word. And focusing on custard and sherry. Charo, good morning, chef.
Great. I always think of the Christmas day like the Grand National.
Oh, right.
Your starter is the first fence.
Oh.
The main course is the next fence, and then in the distance you can see coming towards you this amazing...
That's the final furlong.
..traditional sherry trifle.
I have to say I'm not a trifle fan, Charlo, but I'm quite willing to be...
I've converted you before, haven't I?
You certainly have,
my
friend.
So my challenge is on. So let's
do it.
We have three elements to the trifle, OK?
Nice.
We have the sponge. We're going to set some a raspberry sponge in some sherry.
Oh.
We're going to make an absolutely amazing, show-stopping homemade custard.
Oh.
And then we've chantilly cream. And to top it all off, I'm going to show you how to make the most amazing edible Santi hats.
Oh, now.
So we'll start. Shop bought, or you can make your own Swiss roll. So that's just a shop bought Swiss roll, and have a bit of
material.
Why would
you rather make your own, Charlo, hat?
Exactly. I mean, time is the essence here.
Yes, exactly.
I'm just going to slice these nice thin slices. And you pick out your bowl.
Okay.
I have a nice trifle bowl here.
Lovely.
And we're going to then just line the dish. Now, what you're looking at is maybe two thirds of your dish.
Yeah.
Of your mix up, of your sherry mix. And there we have some Madeira. If you have Madeira cake, which is fantastic.
Oh, so your Madeira in there as well.
Yeah, just showing you as well. You can mix the two of them. I have a little bit of raspberry jam here.
Okay.
And just glue them together.
Yeah.
And then we're just going to cut them into little squares. So it's either or. I like mixing it up a little bit.
Would you say this recipe is not to be trifled with? Thank you, Charlo. I couldn't resist it. I've been thinking, when can I say that? We've got a minute in.
Okay. Well, I have a joke for you now in 1 second, okay?
All right, you have a Christmas joke.
I have a Christmas joke. So we're going to spike this one. Here's the thing, I'm going to spike it with raspberries and peaches.
No. Now, peaches?
Yeah, nice soft fruit. So the peaches are tinned peaches. It's all keeping in the tradition of soft fruit. Like a peach Melba as well, okay?
Lord, look at that.
Okay, now into our bowl then, we have two packets of raspberry jelly.
Okay.
And break them up into cubes.
Okay.
Hot water.
Yeah.
700 mils of hot water.
Okay.
Important then to leave the water come down a small bit, chill down a small bit. Don't put the hot, boiling hot water or your hot mix in on top of your sponge because it'll dissolve everything.
Yeah,
exactly.
Yeah.
And then we have the star of the show, the sherry.
Sherry.
200 mils.
Yeah. 200.
200 mils. We're going to pour this into your jelly. So that's about 200. And then we're going to spike. Because I know it says sherry trifle, it's a drenched sherry trifle. There's no point in inviting people over if we're allowed
to
your house.
We need to. Must have been lashing out brave, is it?
Are we going to pour it, the mixture on top? Can you see that? Amazing.
Absolutely, look at that.
I'm just going to press it down with a ladle. Just press it down a little bit. That's going to set in your fridge overnight. And this is a great dessert because you can make this 2 days before Christmas Day and it's a box ticked.
Oh, very good, yeah, it's off.
Then Christmas Eve, so this is in your fridge, yeah. Christmas Eve then, you have 300 millilitres of milk, 300 millilitres of cream, bring it to the boil, take it off the boil. And in a bowl, you have then seven egg yolks. You've got 80 grams of caster sugar, 20 grams of corn flour.
Okay.
And we have our vanilla. This is great stuff. And it's so cheap now in the shops. Remember years ago, these were very expensive.
They're more expensive than
gold. Yeah, this was like €2. Nice and soft Madagascan vanilla pod. I'm just going to split that down the middle.
Okay.
And then you scrape the seeds out either side. And this goes in, you see? This goes in then to your base.
Very good.
And what we do then, there's a little technique involved here, Simon, okay?
Yeah. Okay.
So we mix the egg yolks, the sugar, and the corn flour, and this is making the most delicious, I'll be looking to get out of here alive when you taste this, custard, homemade custard, as opposed to the shop-bought custard for convenience. Yeah. Try this once, folks, and I mean it, you'll never go back. So here's the trick, here's the technique. You got to add a small bit to your yolk mix, okay, your egg mix. Right. And you got to incorporate. If you add it all in together, it'll scramble on you.
Okay.
And what we do then is, takes a little bit of time, this part. And then we're going to, as you can see, we're diluting all the way.
And that mixture's getting looser as we go.
It's getting looser. Add it all in then when you're happy enough. And then you're going to return it to a low, low heat. Okay. So you're going to return it to a low heat, so bring it all back in.
Okay.
And you can see the lovely vanilla pod seeds in there as well,
yeah.
And the aromas.
Beautiful.
Back onto a low heat. And you need to stay over it then with a wooden spoon. And you need to cook it out and it'll see it tickling. The corn flour thickens it.
How long will that take, Charlo?
About 7 or 8 minutes. Once you see it tickling and it's coating the back of the spoon, take it off. If you want to sieve it, you can sieve it if it's a little bit lumpy. Cool it down, and then you're going to top your trifle. So you've taken your trifle down to just set out of the fridge.
Lovely.
Your cold custard is ready.
Yeah.
And then you spread your cold custard out.
Okay.
Chantilly cream is next then, so it's whipped cream, ice and sugar, and then some more vanilla pod seeds.
Okay. And we'll have all the details up on the website.
Exactly.
Anyway.
I keep these and pop them back into my sugar.
Oh, so you got
and
the flavours.
Okay. Yeah. I'm going to show you really quickly how to make Santa hats.
Very good.
So Oreo biscuit, whipped cream, and some strawberry. Now just take the green little stem off the strawberry.
Okay. Yeah.
Then we're going to a little bobbin at the bottom of fresh cream and a piping bag. Pop your strawberry
on. There's your Santa
on.
Hat.
There's look your Santa that. Hat. A little bobbin here.
Lovely.
I've got to tell you a quick story.
Is this a Christmas
show? I mislaid my trifle dishes.
Oh no.
So I had to send an SOS out. So I'd like to thank Dee and work for giving me your glass that you set yours in.
Oh, thank you, Dee.
And we've got Geraldine as well, Geraldine Denver in Bray.
Very
she's
good.
The goddess of desserts, this lady. We have to go out to her house, Simon.
We'll drop out
you have
Christmas
to have a cup
evening.
Of tea, and you have to taste this lady's desserts. And
really?
Dee's a fabulous cook as well. They gave me a lend
thank
of Dee's for the show today, so thanks a million girls for saving my bacon. We're bringing a little bit of snow, and we have my little elf on the shelf.
Look at that.
And a little trick then, nice presentation, just a few crushed pistachio nuts.
Lovely.
And a few little peaches.
You said you had a Christmas joke.
Santa got a new motorbike. What did he get?
I don't know.
Holly Davidson. A Holly Davidson.
Now that got the thumbs down from Uncle Tony. Caesar has said no.
I want you to taste now.
You want me to taste? No,
oh,
I have to say I'm not a trifle fan, but because you made it, Charlo, I'm quite happy to give it a go. And this red stuff in here is called fruit. Is that right? Yeah. Fruit. Yeah. So this is part of my five a day then.
Now you should. Have I converted you? Can you get the sherry?
Yes.
Can you get the chantilly cream?
Yes.
Can you get the homemade custard?
Yes.
Is it good?
That is sensational. And I love the pistachio nuts at the top.
Yeah, nice crunch.
The custard is phenomenal. And you're right.
And you have your edible Santa hats there. Get the kids involved.
But make the effort of making the custard yourself, because it is sensational.
Sensational. And the Santa hats, get the kids involved. Get the kids involved, get the Santa hats. It's a fantastic show-stopping dessert.
My word.
To end your Christmas meal.
Amazing. We're going to be chatting to you later on.
No problem. I'll hang around there for a few questions.
All recipe details are, of course, up on the website. Or you can check out charlothechef.com for more from the man himself. Now, are you worried about cooking the perfect Christmas dinner next weekend? Well, have no fear, because Charlo's hanging around in the next hour, along with our own Dean Diplock. And they are here to answer all of your culinary queries. You've still got time to send in your questions. Just email ironandam@virginmedia.ie. And Charlo promised that we'll get through as many as we can. Now, up next, 50 years on, we speak to one cameraman who captured some of the Beatles' most intimate moments. Stay with us.